Hey guys, Mike Binder here. I'm going to show you how to play Last Minute Late Night by Kane Brown. So the first thing you're going to want to do is place a capo on the 5th fret. I'm going to play an A minor. To play an A minor, take your index finger and put it on the B string. 1st fret, it's 2 strings from the bottom. Then your middle finger on the D string, 2nd fret, that's 3 strings from the top. And then your ring finger on the G string, 2nd fret. That's 3 strings from the bottom. So what we're going to do is we're going to pluck 3 strings at the same time using our thumb, our index, and our middle. So thumb goes on the D, index on the G, and middle on the B. The easier way to do it is just pluck and then mute the strings by smacking them. You can kind of get that percussive sound going. Now, the way that's done on the recording is there's a bass note thrown in there, so it's like pluck, bass, pluck. And then there's a rest in between there, so. If you want to learn it the harder way, that's cool, but you know, you can also just do it the easy way. It's going to be easier to sing to do it like this. All right, and then so after the A minor, you're going to do an F. So I'll show you the easy way and the hard way. So to play an F, the easy way, just take your index finger, leave it there where it was for A minor, and then add your middle finger to the G string, 2nd fret, and your ring finger to the D string, 3rd fret. So that's the easy F with the easy plucking. Now, if you want to do what's on the recording, take your ring finger and place it on the A string, 3rd fret, and then put your pinky on the D string, 3rd fret. And then you'll pluck those same strings, but then you go down to the A note, the A string, and you pluck that with your thumb. Okay, so for the intro, you do that 2 times, and then the verse, you do it 4 times. And after the 4th time, you'll go to a D minor. Okay, to play a D minor, place your index on the high E string, 1st fret. Your middle finger on the G string, 2nd fret. And then your ring finger on the B string, 3rd fret. So easy way, just pluck, pluck. Hard way. Pluck, bass, pluck. Pluck, bass, pluck. Alright, so after that, we'll go into the chorus. We're going to play an F. And that whole time, I'm just holding the pick in my hand while I'm plucking, and then I just grab the pick, ready to strum. So we'll go down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. So it's down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. I'll put the strum pattern in the description box below with the chords, and you guys can just get a visual of that, track along with the chords if that's helpful. So the chords for the chorus are F, A minor, G. So F is the whole strum pattern, and then A minor, halfway through, you switch to G. So A minor and G share the bar. six times through that chord progression on the chorus. So after that, we'll go back to the verse. Four times through that progression, and then the D minor. And then we're back into the chorus. Do that six times, and then we do the bridge. It's a D minor, A minor, G, D minor, E7. Now let me show you E7 real quick. If you know a normal E, it's just removing your ring finger. So you get that open D string in there. Let me break that down. So take your index finger, place it on the G string, first fret. It's three strings from the bottom. And then your middle finger on the A string, second fret. That's two strings from the top. And the bridge gets the same strum pattern. Down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up. And then D minor, E7, you hold it twice. And then we're back into the chorus, and that's the end of the song.